Hello friends, welcome to new series of teaching aptitude MCQs for the UGC NET and SET examination on Global Online University. And in today's episode, I'll be teaching or I'll be discussing the MCQs from the higher education systems. So rules are simple: pause the video when question appears on your screen and try to answer. So to begin with, first question is UGC was formally established by an act of parliament in the year. Option A is 1961, option B is 1956, option C is 1950 and option D is 1953. So friends, this is memory based question and you should know that UGC was established by an act of parliament in 1956. Let us know more about UGC. So UGC, as I said, was established by act of parliament in 1956 and it comes under the Ministry of Human Resources and Development, and its functions are coordination, determination and maintenance of standards of higher education in India, and it provides the recognition to the university, and it also take care of the funds to such a recognized universities and colleges. And one more important thing, its headquarters is in Delhi and it has 6 regional centers in Pune, Bhopal, Kolkata, Hyderabad, Guwahati and Bangalore. So friends, remember these points. Question may be asked on any of these points. The question which I asked was on the when was it established, but they may also ask its headquarter, where is its headquarter, or they may also ask what are its function, and they may also ask you which ministry the UGC comes under. So you can prepare accordingly. Now next question is, which of the following statements are correct about deemed university? So friends, deemed university are also called private universities. Now the option A is they are established by central government. Option B is they are established by state government. Option C is they can design their own syllabus and course. And D, none of the above. So friends, option A is they are established by central government. When it is established by central government, they are called central universities, like University of Hyderabad, like DU, Delhi universities, like JNU. So these are the central universities. And when they are established by state governments, they are called state universities. So state universities, like there are many state universities like Kolhapur, Shivaji University, like you can have your whichever state you are residing, there are many states universities, they are established by the state government. Now the deemed university, they have this autonomy of having their own syllabus, having their own coursework. In the next slide I'll tell you more about the deemed university. Now the correct answer is they can design their own syllabus and course. So they are not established by state or center, they are established by either private entities or say businessmen or say NGOs. And now moving on to the we'll see detail about the deemed university. So let us know it. The central universities or the union universities are established by act of parliament and they are under the Department of Higher Education. Now state universities, as I said, they are established by act of local legislative assembly. So and there, see, in case of central universities they are funded by center, and in case of state universities they are funded by state. And private universities or deemed university, as I said, they are funded by the private people. Private in the sense they may be NGO, there may be a private businessman or whoever, but for that they are approved by UGC and they can grant degrees. So these are their functions. They can grant their own degrees, and but they are not allowed to have off-campus colleges. So this is the thing about the private or deemed university. And so the more functions which private or deemed university is that they can design their own syllabus and coursework, they can frame their own guidelines regarding the admission and fees, and they can also grant degrees. So friends, remember these things about deemed universities, central university and state universities, because anything, like any question can be asked, like any, they can tune it in other way, who establishes the state universities or what are their autonomy. And one more thing, the in case of state universities, the governor of the state is a vice chancellor, and in case of a state central universities, the president is the vice chancellor. So remember these things. And in case of the deemed university, the governor is not a vice chancellor, they have their appointed vice chancellor. This is one major difference that you should remember. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following statement is correct about the NAC? So what is NAC? Is National Assessment and Accreditation Council. So option A is it is an autonomous institution. Option B is it is tasked with the responsibility of distributing funds to colleges. And option C is it is located in Delhi. And option D is it has regional offices. So friends, NAC is not, it does not have any responsibility of distributing the funds. As we studied earlier, UGC has the responsibility of distributing the funds. So option B is eliminated, and its headquarters is located in Bangalore and not in Delhi. Remember this. And it has regional offices, so it doesn't have any regional office. It has only one office, that is in Bangalore. So only one option, that is it is an autonomous institute, it is correct, and it is under the UGC. Now let us know more about the NAC. So NAC is an organization that helps in assessing and accreditation of the higher education institution in India, and it is an autonomous body funded by UGC, and its headquarters is in Bangalore. So friends, these are the points that you should remember in case of NAC. So there will be question on either UGC, NAC or the other bodies of the government. Now friends, moving on to the next question. Prime Minister's Research Fellowship is for students pursuing PhD program in. So friends, last year in the year 2018, our Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji has launched this PMRF fellowship. So generally they said that while in the notification it was said that there will be 1,000 PhD fellowships. And what is the important thing about this PMRF fellowship? It is that fellowship amount is a little higher or more than what generally we get for doing PhD in India. Generally people get around 28 or 25,000 per month, but in this fellowship the research scholar would he will get 70,000 for first 2 years, and then it will increase to 85,000 or something for the next 3 years for his PhD. So this PMRF was launched, but sadly the when they notified it was 1,000 fellowships, but the actual result came and there were only 150 candidates selected. But now knowing going to the question, Prime Minister's Research Fellowship is for student pursuing PhD program in which state and central university, be central university, IISc, IIT, NIT, IISER, IITs, and option C is IISc, IITs, NITs, IISERs, IITs, state and central universities, and D is IITs and IISc. So friends, the correct answer to this is, now they have also included the central universities after one and IISERs. After one more modification to the rule. So the state university is ruled out. They have not included the state universities for the PMRF fellowship. So remember this, the state universities are not in the list where you can take this PMRF fellowship. So the correct answer for this is option B, central university, IISc, IIT, NITs, IISERs and IITs. So friends, this was it in today's lecture. If you have liked it and if you have some suggestions, please post it in comment section. And if you have liked it, please share, like, comment or subscribe to our channel Global Online University. Thank you.